गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस सेशन इज फॉर क्लास ट्वेल्थ। इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड हाउ करेंट कैरिंग लूप बिहेव्स लाइक ए मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल, एंड देन वी कंपेयर्ड दैट द मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल एंड इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल टुगेदर, एंड वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इलेक्ट्रिक डाइपोल एंड मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल, एंड वी सॉ देयर वॉज अ ग्रेट इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल, दैट इज इट इज़ द स्मॉलेस्ट मैग्नेटिक एलिमेंट। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल अबाउट द मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल मोमेंट ऑफ रिवॉल्विंग इलेक्ट्रॉन इन हाइड्रोजन एटम। ओके सो लेट स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक लेट अस रिकॉल समथिंग विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड इन क्लास 11th। सो लेट सी about Bohr model of hydrogen atom. You may perhaps have heard of this model which was proposed by Danish physicist Niels Bohr. Students, this model we have completed in class 11th. But let us take a quick revision about this. So you know that this model is based on the quantum mechanics. Okay. In this, a negatively electron or you can say negatively charged particle revolves around a positively charged nucleus, much as planet revolves around the sun. So this is very similar to the, like earth revolves around the sun, the electron revolves around the positive charge nucleus. Okay, the force of in the former case in electrostatic Coulomb's force, while it is gravitational. So in case of earth and sun it is gravitational force, while in case of electron and nucleus it is electrostatic or you can say Coulomb force. Okay, so we saw this picture of electron in figure 4.23. you can see here in this picture this one is the nucleus and electron revolves around the nucleus on a circular path of radius r, you can see here. Okay, so in this figure 4.23, in the Bohr model of hydrogen like atom, the negatively charged electron is revolving with the uniform speed around the centrally placed positively charged nucleus. The uniform circular motion of the electron constitutes a current, and the direction of the magnetic moment is into the plane of the paper, and it is directed separately by this symbol means it is perpendicular and inward. Okay, so what is meaning of this statement? Student, you can see this one is the picture for hydrogen like atom. You can see hydrogen like atom means atom which contains only one electron. It can have more than one proton, but number of electron must be one. So these are known as hydrogen like atoms. Okay, hydrogen like atoms. So suppose helium ion, if you write He plus, this one is also hydrogen like atom because this contains only one electron and two protons. Since you know that for helium the atomic number is 2, so the number of proton is 2, but number of electron in helium plus is only 1. Okay, so this type of structure is known as hydrogen like atom. Similarly, lithium, you can write lithium plus plus. So this one is also hydrogen like atom because in this case you can see this lithium contains only one electron. So these are known as hydrogen like atoms. Okay, so you can see here the electron is revolving on a circular path around the nucleus which is at center of this circular track. Okay, the uniform circular motion of the electron constitutes a current. Now you know that the moving electrons are equivalent to current. So you can see electron is moving on this track anti-clockwise. It means there is a current in clockwise direction, since we are taking current opposite to the motion of electron. So direction of current is clockwise. Okay, this one is the direction of current here. Okay, now you can see the direction of magnetic moment is into the plane of paper and is indicated separately. So you can see the direction of magnetic moment is perpendicular and invert. It is given by right hand rule, so you can find out the direction of this magnetic moment. So we have completed this paragraph till here. Okay, let's see. The electron of charge minus e means minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. For proton it is plus. Perform a uniform circular motion around the stationary heavy nucleus of charge plus Zd. Student, where Z is atomic number. So if you consider this helium, so for helium it is plus 2 because it is nucleus is positively charged, plus 2e. Okay, since there are two protons, so plus 2, and the e is charge on proton, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, so this is actually the total charge on the nucleus. Similarly, for lithium double plus ion, this will be plus 3 because there is no change in number of proton inside the nucleus. There is only change in number of electrons in orbits. Okay, so this constitutes a current I, where I is found to be E by T. So I is equal to E by T. Now, since we know that the current I is defined as the charge by the time, okay, so charge Q by time. So in one complete rotation or one complete revolution, you can see the total charge remains constant, and that is equal to the electronic charge, and the time period of this circle is taken as the time here. So T is the time period of revolution. Let R be the orbital radius of the electron and V be the orbital speed. Then we can write T is equal to, in one complete rotation, it will be 2 pi R upon V, where V is uniform. So it is 2 pi R upon V. Now you can replace this value of T, or you can substitute this value of T from equation 4.33 to equation number 4.32. Okay. So if you substitute this value of T in equation number 4.32, you will get this result. You can see, substituting equation 4.32, we get I is equal to EV upon 2 pi R. Okay, so this one is the value of current, this current due to the electron in hydrogen like atom. Now the magnetic moment is denoted by mu L. This letter is known as mu, and this one is L subscript. Okay, so this magnetic moment is actually denoted by this mu L, and this mu L is associated with this circulating current from equation 4.28. It is magnitude is given by, this is actually the magnetic moment, you can say. So this magnetic moment is defined as M is equal to I into A. We have already defined this magnetic moment. For hydrogen like atoms, this M is replaced by mu L. Okay, so this M is replaced by mu L. So you can see this mu L is actually the magnetic moment. This is M. Okay, so this M is equal to I into pi R square. So you can see radius of the circular path is R. So the total area of this circle is pi R square into current I. So you can substitute the value of I, this value of I, in here. So the direction of this magnetic moment is into the plane of paper. This is already discussed, and this follows the right hand rule discussed earlier. And fact, the negatively charged electron is moving anticlockwise, leading to clockwise current. So these things we have already discussed. Okay, now multiplying the multiplying and dividing the right hand side of above expression by the electronic mass me, we get. So if you multiply and divide this part, you can see here, this, if you put the value of I here, this is EV upon 2 pi R, then you will get EVR upon 2. Okay, now we are going to multiply by ME and divide by ME. So you can see here E VR. So E VR into ME upon 2 into ME, because ME and ME are multiplied and divide. Okay, so after that, this MVR is equal to the एंगुलर मोमेंटम, यू नो दैट एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज डिफाइंड एज द पी इंटू आर एंड पी इज इक्वल टू एम वी. सो दिस वन इज एक्चुअली एम वी इंटू आर. ओके सो यू कैन सी हियर म्यू एल इज इक्वल टू ई बाई टू एम ई एम वी आर. सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू ई बाई टू एम ई इंटू एल बिकॉज दिस वन इज द एंगुलर मोमेंटम, दिस पार्ट इज एंगुलर मोमेंटम. सो यू कैन सी हियर हियर एल इज मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन अबाउट द सेंट्रल न्यूक्लियस दैट इज ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम. ओके द एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑर्बिटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम. सो इन वेक्टर फॉर्म यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस दैट इज सिंस दीज टू आर अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन दिस सो दैट द नेगेटिव साइन इंडिकेट्स दैट द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन इज अपोजिट इन डायरेक्शन टू मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. यू कैन सी दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली. सो द मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज ऑलवेज इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन टू द इट्स मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. यू कैन सी हियर दिस नेगेटिव साइन इंडिकेट्स दैट द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन इन अपोजिट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. इंस्टीड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विथ चार्ज माइनस ई, इफ वी हैड टेकन अ पार्टिकल विथ चार्ज प्लस क्यू द एंगुलर मोमेंटम एंड द मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट वुड बी इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. ओके सो यू कैन सी द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रिजल्ट्स हियर. सो इफ वी टेक द पॉजिटिव चार्ज रिवॉल्विंग ऑन द सेम सर्कुलर पाथ देन द मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट एंड द एंगुलर मोमेंटम मस्ट बी इन सेम डायरेक्शन. सो द इक्वेशन बिकम्स लाइक दिस. There is no negative sign here because both of them are in same direction and it's called the gyromagnetic ratio. This is known as gyromagnetic ratio. This is very important question for 1 marks. Okay, so this one is known as gyromagnetic ratio. This is mu L upon L. Okay, and is constant. It is constant. Its value is found to be 8.8 into 10 to the power 10 coulomb per kilogram. So this is the value of the gyromagnetic ratio for electron which has been verified by experiment. Okay, the fact that even at an atomic level there is a magnetic moment confirms Ampere-Boltz hypothesis of atomic magnetic moments. This according to Ampere would help one to explain the magnetic properties of materials. Okay, so student, the meaning of this statement is that even the smallest part, that is the atom, if you are talking about the atom, in atom there is electron which is revolving around the nucleus. It means it is also like this you have already discussed for hydrogen atom. These two are similar. So you can see here, even at atomic level there is magnetic moment. Because all these are behaves like an atom in which electron revolving around nucleus. Okay. Now, would help to this according to Ampere would help one to explain the magnetic properties of material. So this is very important to explain the magnetic properties of materials. One can assign a value of this atomic dipole moment. Now we can calculate the values of this atomic magnetic moment. You can see here the answer is yes, one can do so within the Bohr model. Bohr hypothesized that angular momentum assumes a discrete set of values. So since we have completed the Bohr atomic model in which the angular momentum L is always integral multiple of h by 2 pi where h is Planck's constant. This was one of the hypotheses. This is h. So h by 2 pi. This was one of the hypotheses of Planck in, sorry, this was one of the hypotheses of Bohr in his atomic model. So you can see here, this one is the hypothesis. And that is the angular momentum L is always integral multiple of h by 2 pi where n is taken as 1, 2, 3 and so on. So the constant h, named as the Planck's constant, The value is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. ठीक है, this is the value of the Planck constant. This condition of discreteness is called Bohr quantization condition. So this one is known as Bohr's quantization condition. We shall discuss it in detail in chapter 12. We will again study about the atomic models in our 12th chapter, but I am continuously revising the things because we have completed this section of Bohr atomic model in class 11th. Okay, we have completed there Thomson's atomic model, then Rutherford's atomic model, then Bohr's atomic model. So I hope you remember. If not, let's see here. This is the assumption, that is, the orbital angular momentum of moving electron is always integral multiple of h by 2 pi, where h is Planck's constant. Okay, this is also known as Bohr's quantization condition. Okay, here Rm is merely to use it to calculate the elementary dipole moment. So by this value we can find out dipole moment. Let's see how we can take or we can find out this. So let's take n is equal to 1. If you take n is equal to 1, you will get mu l is equal to e upon 4 pi m e into h. Since l is equal to this, so you can replace l by this value. Okay, let me show you the equation first. So you can see here mu is equal to e by 2 m e into l. So since mu is equal to e by 2m into l, and this l is the orbital angular momentum. Now you can use this value of l, so it will be e by 2m into n h by 2 pi. Okay, now for first orbital you can replace this n by 1, so you can write mu is equal to e by 2m into h by 2 pi. So you can see the same equation here. Mu L is equal to E upon 2 into 2, 4 into pi into m. So you can see 4 pi m e into h. Okay, now replace values, or you can substitute all the values because all the terms are known. So you can use at the place of E 1.6, at the place of H, sorry, at the place of E 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, at the place of H the values of H, that is 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34, then value of pi, that is 3.14, and ME, that is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31. So after calculation of these values, you will get 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. This is the unit of this magnetic dipole moment. Okay, so since n is equal to 1 is the smallest value, you are getting here the smallest value of magnetic moment. Okay, so where the subscript mean stands for the minimum, and this value is called the Bohr magnetron. This is very important question. This is Bohr magnetron. Okay, so this is the value of Bohr magnetron. Okay, so I hope you remember this condition, that is 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 34 minus 24 sorry ampere meter square. This is the value of Bohr's magnetron. This is the smallest value of magnetic moment, that is for hydrogen atom. Okay, or you can say hydrogen like atom. Now, any change in uniform circular motion would have an associated magnetic moment given by expression 4.34. This dipole moment is labeled as the orbital magnetic moment. Hence, the subscript L is mu L. Besides the orbital moment, the electron has an intrinsic magnetic moment, which has the same numerical value as in 4.37. It is called the spin magnetic moment, but we have to add that it is not an as though the electron is spinning. The electron is an elementary particle and it does not have an axis to spin around like a top or earth. Nevertheless, it does possess this intrinsic magnetic moment. The microscopic root of magnetism in iron and other materials can be traced back to this intrinsic spin magnetic moment. So students, in this case it is said that in this case we are not considering that the electron is spinning around its own axis like the earth is spinning around its own axis when it is orbiting around the sun. So in this section it is not considered here. Okay, here it is considered that the electron is continuously revolving around the nucleus of positive charge Zd. In higher studies we will consider the spin magnetic effect due to spin of electron also, but here it is enough to consider that the electron is revolving around the nucleus with its speed v, and the Bohr magnetron for this process is given by 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. So what are very important discussion for this section? Let us take a quick revision about the important discussion about this topic. That is, this topic is based on the Bohr atomic model, so you must remember the Bohr atomic model first. Then I defined E by T, this is the basic definition of current. After that you replace the time interval by the simple formula, that is distance upon time, that is 2 pi r upon v for one complete revolution. Then replace this T by this value, substituting value of T, and you will get the magnetic moment in terms of E, V and R. Now we are changing this magnetic dipole moment in form of the angular momentum, because in Bohr atomic model the orbital angular momentum is related to the angular momentum of the particle. So this equation is changing in form of the orbital angular momentum of electron, and now it takes like this. Here L is the orbital angular momentum. Now by using right hand rule for electron as a particle and for the current in the loop, we will get that the direction of magnetic dipole moment is perpendicular and inward the plane of paper, whereas the direction of angular momentum for electron is perpendicular and outward the plane of paper. So in this case you can see these two are opposite to each other. Okay, so angular momentum is opposite to the magnetic dipole moment. This is very important discussion, this is very important result. But there is a positive charge. If there is a positive charge revolving around the nucleus, suppose that is a proton or any other positive charge which also behaves like a current, so in that case the positive charge and the magnetic moment due to motion of this positive charge are in the same direction, and we will write the equation like this, means without negative sign. And this ratio is known as the gyromagnetic ratio. This is very important, this is gyromagnetic ratio. It means for a moving charge particle the ratio of magnetic moment to its angular momentum is defined as the gyromagnetic ratio, and its value is constant. And it is, you can see here, E by 2 Me is constant for all the atoms, so it is constant for all the atoms. And it is 8.8 into 10 to the power 10 कूलम पर केजी. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट. ओके सो यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दिस रिजल्ट. फॉर एन इलेक्ट्रॉन विच हैज बीन वेरीफाइड, सो दिस हैज बीन वेरीफाइड बाई एक्सपेरिमेंट्स इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस. एंड फाइनली यू कैन चेंज दिस इक्वेशन इन फॉर्म ऑफ एच फॉर सिंपल कैलकुलेशन. सो सिंस एल इज इक्वल टू NH by 2 pi, so you can replace this L by NH by 2 pi and you will get this result, that is EH upon 4 pi ME for first orbit, since N is replaced by 1 here. Okay, and then you will get the minimum possible magnetic moment for hydrogen like atoms, and this one is the minimum, and the value of this minimum value you can calculate by substituting the values of all the constant given in this equation. You can see in this part all the terms are constant and it is independent of the atomic number. It means this is true for all the hydrogen like atoms. And after substituting the values of pi ME and after calculation, you will get the value that is 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square, where ampere meter square is the unit of this magnetic moment. We already know about this. And the subscript mean means the minimum. This mean, that is, stand for minimum value. So this minimum value is called the Bohr magnetron. This is very important question for 1 marks. What is value of Bohr magnetron? Many times this question asked by CBSC or many other examinations. So you must remember the value, that is 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. That is the value of Bohr magnetron. Bohr magnetron means the minimum possible value of magnetic moment for hydrogen like atoms. Okay, so this is very interesting and very important result. And also you remember the value of gyromagnetic ratio for hydrogen like atoms or any other atom, because this is always constant for all, and the value is 8.8 into 10 to the power 10 coulomb per kg. You can see here I am talking about this value. This one is gyromagnetic ratio. This is also very important numerical value, so you must remember these two values. Now in this section we consider that the electron is revolving around the nucleus on circular orbit of radius r. Okay. In this case, it is not considered that the electron is also spinning around its own axis. And since in actual practice, the electron are also spinning in and revolving around the nucleus, same as the Earth spinning as well as revolving around the sun. Okay, so in this case the magnetic moment produced by the spin motion of electron is not considered. Okay, so these things we will study in higher classes. Okay, so you can see by using these properties of magnetism, by which is developed by spin of electron, is used to explain the magnetic properties of materials. Okay, so students, I hope you understand the concept of magnetic moment. Okay, magnetic moment for hydrogen like atoms. So to study this topic, I am giving you one advice, and that is first revise Bohr atomic model in detail. Okay students, this one is very important topic for CBSC exams. This topic, that is known as magnetic dipole moment, ये एग्जाम में कई बार पूछा जा चुका है. ठीक है, इसको बहुत अच्छे से आपको प्रिपेयर कर लेना चाहिए. और इसमें डायरेक्शंस की जो खास बात है कि अगर आप इलेक्ट्रॉन यहाँ पे कंसीडर करते हैं तो एंगुलर मोमेंटम और मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट जो होता है वो अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में चला जाता है, जबकि अगर इसको हम पॉजिटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल मान लें तो मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट और एंगुलर मोमेंटम की डायरेक्शन सेम हो जाती है. दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिजल्ट. इसके साथ आपको जानना होगा कि जो न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज आ रही हैं और उनके डिफरेंट टर्म्स दिए जा रहे हैं, जैसे कि जायरोमैग्नेटिक रेशियो और उसकी वैल्यू क्या है, कैसे जायरोमैग्नेटिक रेशियो डिफाइंड है, जैसे कि बोर मैग्नेट्रॉन कैसे डिफाइंड है और उसकी न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यू क्या है, तो ये सब आपको बहुत ही अच्छे से पता होना चाहिए, ठीक है। इस चीज़ों को रिवाइज़ करिए, बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक है, पढ़ेंगे अच्छा लगेगा, ठीक है। और जो टॉपिक प्रीवियस पढ़ाए गए हैं उनको कंटिन्यूसली रिवाइज़ करते रहिए, न्यूमेरिकल्स सॉल्व करते रहिए, सभी टॉपिक पे टॉपिक के साथ ही आप अपने न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करते चले जाएंगे, तो आपको चीज़ें ज़्यादा इजी समझ में आएंगी। आप समझिए हाइड्रोजन लाइक एटम्स कौन से होते हैं, ऐसे सभी एटम जिनमें सिर्फ एक ही इलेक्ट्रॉन है उसको हाइड्रोजन लाइक एटम्स कहते हैं। प्रोटॉन कितने भी हो कोई मैटर नहीं करता, इलेक्ट्रॉन सिर्फ एक ही होना चाहिए, उस तरह के सभी एटम्स को हम लोग हाइड्रोजन लाइक एटम मानते हैं। ओके, सो थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग। नेक्स्ट सेशन में हम लोग गैल्वेनोमीटर के बारे में पढ़ेंगे। थैंक यू।